Welcome to our channel, AI Tech Explorers. Are you ready to experience the future of AI technology on your Mac? Look no further than the new Bing Chat with AI from Microsoft. With the Edge app, you'll have access to an AI-powered assistant that can help you with anything you need, from searching the web to managing your daily tasks. And the best part? It's completely free. In this video, I'll show you how to get started with Edge so you can take your Mac to the next level. So sit back, relax, and get ready to explore the cutting-edge world of AI with iTech Explorers. If you are searching for the Microsoft Edge app on the App Store for your Mac, then unfortunately, you won't be able to find it. This is because the Edge app is not currently available for Mac devices. It is available for other platforms, such as Windows and mobile devices. The version for Mac is available through the Microsoft Edge Insider program at microsoftedgeinsider.com. This program allows users to test new features and updates before they are released to the general public. Scroll down to the section named Check Out the Microsoft Edge Insider Channels and click on the link download page. I recommend downloading the beta channel version of the app, which is the most stable. I have been using it for a few weeks now and it works perfectly without any problems. Then you select the version of your Mac, whether it's with an Apple or Intel chip, and download the app. Now, we run the downloaded package and follow the instructions to install it. After installation, we will run Microsoft Edge. And voila, we have a new Edge with new chat Bing in the right corner. If you want to use the new Bing with AI, you need to be logged into your Microsoft account. Or you can create a new one on the web at account.microsoft.com/account. If this video is helpful to you, please show your support with a thumbs up. And to ensure you don't miss out on our future content, hit the subscribe button. Let's go back to our Edge and the new Bing. On the right side, we have similar functionality as in ChatGPT. But it can be said that the interface is more sophisticated, divided into three parts. The first is Chat, the second is Compose, and the third is Insights. Let's start with Chat. Here you can set the tone to be creative, balanced, and precise. We'll leave the default settings and ask what day it is. That's right. Today is March 27th, 2023. We will continue by asking what movie won the Oscar this year. The answer is that the movie that won the Oscar is Everything Everywhere All at Once. This is different from ChatGPT, which is not connected to the internet. So let's try asking ChatGPT the same question intentionally. We select GPT-4. I'm sorry, but my knowledge only goes up until September 2021, and I cannot provide real-time information. To find out which movie won the Oscar for Best Picture in the most recent Academy Awards, please consult a current news source or visit the official Oscars website. Now I'd like to show you another advantage of the new Bing sidebar. For an example, let's open this article that compares the 14-inch MacBook Pro with the Galaxy ProBook 3. Can you write a short summary of this article? Here we have the result. Samsung's February notebook launches include the Galaxy Book 3 Pro 14, featuring a dynamic AMOLED display and a 13th gen Intel processor. The Galaxy Book 3 Pro is a high-end notebook that puts together quite a few impressive features, including a high-quality display and a fast chip, and the summary continues with further information. Bing can collaborate with content that is in the browser. I find this feature great for specific use cases. Now let's take a look at the Compose tab. Here we can choose a professional, casual, enthusiastic, informational, and funny tone. The format can be a paragraph, email, blog post, and ideas. And length can be short, medium, or long. We'll try to get Bing to write an email to our customer. Write to the customer, apologizing for not receiving an order confirmation. We are already preparing the order and sending it to his address tomorrow. I'll maintain a professional tone and choose the email format while keeping the length medium. And here is the result. Dear customer, we are writing to you regarding your recent order on our website. We apologize for the inconvenience caused by not receiving an order confirmation email from us. This was due to a technical issue on our end that we are working to resolve as soon as possible. Please rest assured that your order has been received and processed by our team. We are already preparing your order, and we will ship it to your address tomorrow. You will receive a tracking number and an estimated delivery date once your order is dispatched. We appreciate your patience and understanding in this matter. We value your business, and we hope you enjoy your purchase. If you have any questions or concerns, please do not hesitate to contact us at support@website.com. Thank you for choosing us. I think it's a nicely crafted email where you just need to fill in the specifics and send. It is for completeness. We look at the last tab of Bing. So here are just suggestions for search queries. That's all for today. I hope you enjoyed the video, and we will be pleased if you let us know in the comments if you have tried the new Bing and what your experience with it has been, or if you are going to start using it and for what purpose. Thanks for tuning in, and we'll see you the next time.